When I started learning to code 4 years ago, I was just like you. I had no idea. I simply searched YouTube for how to code, and before I knew it, there were thousands of videos to choose from. I found myself stuck, not knowing what to pick, endlessly scrolling for hours in search for a perfect tutorial. But stop. Before learning to code, you need to have written down these three main things. What should I learn? Why should I learn? How should I earn? You might have seen videos saying how I learned to code and got a 100k job in 3 months. Yeah, it's possible, just like you winning a lottery. But how many of you have really won a lottery? Don't ever try to put a time frame and say, within this month, you will be a better developer. Believe me, no one really cares if you're a better developer or just an okay-ish developer. All that matters is whether you can sit and cry looking at your code and get the freaking job done. This brings us back to the previous point. What should you learn? There are many areas where you can deviate. Web development, app development, AI, ML, front-end, back-end, full stack, and tons of others. There should be a particular reason for choosing one, and it is totally up to you. Just because your friend is good at something, that doesn't mean you have to follow his way. This brings back us to the question number 2. Why should you learn? You might have different interests and thought processes. Sometimes you are into make some good money as fast as possible. In that case, you should go for web development, as every business needs a website and every website needs a web developer. But if you want to build something more interesting and feel like a god, you should pick something else like AI and proudly write AI developer in your Twitter bio for flexing. You should really find what strikes you, and even if you can't find something immediately, don't worry, just pick something and later jump to your interest. Learning to code is not literally learning to code. You don't want to learn thousands of max theorems and some freaking syntax about some languages. I'm really sorry if I'm freaking you out. Coding is all about bringing a solution or something. If you have ever used platforms like LeetCode and felt, what the heck, I need to solve this problem to become a developer, it's not really like that. You should have a mindset to solve the problem. You either have to have an experience working with a similar problem, or you should have the ability to learn about that problem. The one who focuses on problem solving rather than learning some syntax will have an exponential potential. Take the example of me. I know how to build a decent website as I have been doing it for over 3 to 4 years, but right now there are a lot of no-code tools like Framer that can create a website just by dragging and dropping, and also we have some AI tools which can create UI components just by typing some keywords. See, now you have just lost your job. That's because you simply focused on something that can be done without really having to solve a problem. If you build your problem solving skill, you can just go to the next level, which is learning how to learn. If you learn how to learn, dude, you already rock. Some folks use blogs, videos, GitHub to learn. Some use tutorial-based learning, while others use project-based learning. Each way is good if you know how to move forward and don't get stuck somewhere. This now brings us back to the third point. How should you learn? You always learn something to earn something. And if you think you can't code, just become an influencer and make tons of money. If you can code, build some software that will help someone, and in return, they will pay you money. Some people also sell code boilerplates and make tons of money. See, there's a market for everything. If you can't do this, just be a normal guy and just apply for a job. There are always enough jobs for you. You just need to find your way to find it. But hey, why should I learn new things rather than just sticking to one thing? I know you have heard about Jack of all trades, master of none. No one really wants to be Jack, but being a Jack is much better than anything. Everything is changing. Your favorite language, let it be JavaScript, it will probably be dead in the next 10 years. There will be thousands of new libraries that will be coming, and you need to be that nerd and have that skill to learn, unlearn, and relearn. Because if you don't do that, you will be sitting in front of your computer watching these videos, and the other guy will be probably talking to a Y Combinator investor for $100 million funding for his new startup. Now let's get back to the real question. How do you start? Dude, if you are mature enough to search for how to code, you already know how to start, what to start. Just start learning and improve your pace and progress. And don't ever compare yourself with someone who has 10 years of experience. Every teacher was once a student, and one day you will be writing code that might help us to colonize Mars. If you want to be spoon-fed, coding is not for you. To be honest, after some time, it's really fun. That's why I want to share my fun thoughts and ideas here on this channel. So make sure you subscribe to my channel, as it is free. You know?